Okay, in this video I want to create a use mail merge in order to create certificates of completion for a class of students. So what I've done already is I've got a certificate of completion, a mock one here, and I've got it created. It's got its template logo and stuff like that, and I put in some of my own text, and I've also put in a generic student name. However, I've got 29 students in the class, and I would like to create a certificate of completion for each of the 29 students. Now, what the certificate already contains is information that's going to be the same for everybody. Of course, this is a generic student name, but otherwise it's all the same date and stuff like that, and there's lines where the instructor and the president can sign these before they're given out. Now, to do a mail merge, I need to have a document, which is going to be my template for the merge, and I also need to have some source data. Now, I've already got an Excel spreadsheet that contains some information on some mock people. I've got names, first names, last names, job titles, phone numbers, addresses, and stuff like that. Now, for addresses and business names, I would probably use those if I was making mailing labels. Now, for my certificate of completion, I'm really only going to need the first names and the last names, but that's okay. My data set has more information than what I need. Now, once you've got your document ready in Word, you're going to go over to the Mailings tab. And now I'm going to select my recipients. So there's a drop-down choice. Now, I don't need to type a new list. I'm going to use an existing list. Now, I'm going to find my data source. My data source is currently saved to my desktop. Let's see, it's in my customer details, and it's my spreadsheet right here, customer details. Yep, that's the table, that's good. Click OK. Alrighty. Now that I've got that set up, now I'm going to insert merge fields. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and delete where I have this generic name, Sally Student. I'll just go ahead and delete that. And I'm going to insert the first name. By the way, these are all the fields from my Excel spreadsheet. So before I insert that, let me just remind you, on my Excel spreadsheet I have company, first name, last name, job title, and so forth. And your Excel spreadsheet should be set up similarly, where the first row contains the labels for the data, which is in the rows below that. So back at Word, insert merge field, I can insert first name, and see it's right in there. Then I can do a space, and then I can insert last name. Now, mine's going on two separate lines. Now, that may or may not happen in real life. Now, although I'm showing it going on two lines here, if the person's first name was Joe, something like that, a very short name, it very would likely fit on one line. So I'm going to keep it like this. And then, after I start to see my certificates of completion, if I see that some people's certificates have their names split on two lines, I might fix those individually. Alright, but otherwise, that's all it takes. I've done the mail merge. And notice, too, if they go on two lines, it's going to mess this part up down here. So it's really important, after you do a mail merge, to kind of skim through and make sure each of the individuals looks good. If I might be concerned about that, I could stretch this up a little taller, I could change the font size for my names and so forth. But otherwise, I'm doing great. Now, next order of business is to start to do the finish and merge. And you can see there's a little drop down for that. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit individual documents. I certainly never recommend going straight to the print unless you are the mail merge master supreme. I'm just going to go to individual documents. Yes, all records. And it's creating all my certificates of completion. What Word is doing, it's creating a new document for me, and each page within my document is going to be a unique certificate of completion. So let me zoom out for a bit here so I can see a little bit more. And I see Elizabeth Anderson, Catherine Atira McConey, Thomas Axon, John Edwards, Anna Bedges, Jean-Philippe Bagel. So I've got a lot of certificates of completion, so I've got a big multi-page document. So I see that there are quite a few names going on to multiple lines, so that's something I could look into fixing. And since it seems to be quite a few, I could might be too time-consuming to fix them individually. So instead, I might see if I can change my design a little bit to better accommodate names that might need to go on multiple lines. So here's what I'm going to do. Since I have a new document, this is not my original document, I have no problems whatsoever closing this document out and not saving it. But I still have my original one, so that's okay. And let's see, I could stretch this text box a bit taller, and then I could ensure that there's some space in between these last lines here. So now if a name is double, or even if you could imagine three lines, it's still, well, that might be a little bit too much there, but even a three-line name still might be okay. So let me see how this looks. It's still ready to go, first name and last name. Let me go ahead and do a merge, edit individual documents, all records, and it's going to kind of redo that process again. Here's my documents, and I see a person with a two-line name. That seems to fit just fine. Let me zoom out a bit. Okay, so two-line names look really good. Let me zoom out a bit more. Okay, let me scroll through a bit. So occasionally I get a three-line name, and I still think that's going to be manageable for my signature line. So I think I'm in pretty good shape. Now once I'm ready for this, this is what I like, fantastic. I can go right to the printer, or even if I'm going to go to the printer or not, I will certainly save as, and I can save this as Certificates of Completion, and this can be for the May 21st workshop. Save. So now they're ready to send off to somebody else for printing, or ready to go to the printer right here.